they're a safe vehicle. They're kind of confined and they're kind of small.
We hear about roadside bombs in Iraq all the time, but what happens when they explode? And how do soldiers train to escape? Long before any Iowan gets deployed to the Middle East, they go through months, even years of training.
Last night, if you were with us, you saw that Eric Hansen showed us how that includes things like video weapons training and helicopter missions. But tonight, he's back inside the Iowa National Guard with training that can leave you a little disoriented. Eric.
That's for sure, Kevin. You wonder which end is up. Military vehicles are built to protect soldiers. But what happens when you need to quickly escape? I climbed in to find out.
Of all the vehicles you'll find at Camp Dodge, this armor-plated beast might be most likely to demand a second look, especially from the enemy.
Generally, they have learned that they don't want to mess with this vehicle.
This is an armored security vehicle, or ASV. It's also called a Guardian.
The primary purpose for this vehicle is for the military police to escort convoys up and down the main supply routes.
This 32,000-pound safe on wheels can blow through water, scale steps, and roll cross-country thanks to its high clearance. But its tight quarters and tiny bulletproof windows make driving it a nightmare.
When you sit in your car, you can see out the front window. Imagine that window that size now. And you got a smaller one on the other side.
Which is why it takes a crew of three. While heading for the range, we stuck our heads out the top. Where we were going, everyone had to be inside.
You can see from the bottom of the hull that it's a V-hull, helps deflect the blast.
In a back corner of Camp Dodge, trainers had planted a surprise, a mock IED, or roadside bomb.
What do we look for is just things that look out of place. In this scenario, branches on the road, they're out of place. They're not where they should be.
We knew this was harmless powder, but the blast made everyone flinch.
In this vehicle, the crew would probably not have been injured or wounded. We would have sustained some damage, probably some tire damage and under chassis damage that's easy to repair. Though.
When bombs explode, drivers react, but that's about as specific as the guard will get. They don't want to share their escape game plan with the enemy. These 16-ton giants rarely roll over when they're hit, but these do.
A Humvee flips or, you know, it lands on its side for whatever reason, it's very difficult to get out.
Humvees are so vulnerable to roll, every guard member has to get flipped and get out.
The doors weigh about anywhere from 300 to 400 pounds, so when you're upside down, you fit. You know, it takes a lot of effort to get out of them.
Okay.
After being outfitted in 60 pounds of equipment, I'm belted in.
Batmobile 2, I'm going to flip you 180 degrees. Do not release your seatbelt.
And the Humvee on a pivot begins to roll, sending loose items in the backseat flying.
Oh, man. Yep, we're upside down.
Hanging by only a seatbelt.
That'll send the blood to your head.
The escape exercise begins.
Egress.
Okay, just unlock the seatbelt.
Yep.
Oh, if I can reach it.
If your vehicle is in the water, if it's submerged, or if it's on fire, of course, time is a main factor.
Should have looked to see where the door handle was.
By the time I swung open the 400-pound door, I'd been hanging more than a minute.
That's harder than it looks.
And I hadn't been through the trauma of an enemy attack. From escaping to driving and shooting to flying, practice makes reactions second nature. And that's the key.
We got to be ready, whether it's here at home to help fellow Iowans or someplace overseas in the combat zone, we've got to be ready to go.
In everything they do, guard members work on a crawl, walk, run system. First, they get the basics, crawling. Then they ramp up the training a little bit to walking. Finally, they go all out at full speed, running. That's how they do all those things. At times, the training can get repetitive for the guard members, but the more they practice, the more they become second nature when the stress of combat happens, and you just got to go second nature.
Yeah, there are so many details that you just don't even think
Absolutely.
About.
Absolutely, and those are just a few of the drills that they do. They do a lot of things up there.
Wow, that's great. Thank you, Eric.
Past 2 nights have really been interesting. Thanks.